neighbors. Everybody needs good neighbors with a little understanding. You can find the perfect blend. Neighbors should be there for one another. That's when good neighbors become good friends.
You lost all my money.
Sorry, Dad.
You morons! You drongos! You threw all my money! All my money! You
threw
all my money!
Calm down, someone's getting upset about.
I am not upset!
Come on, Dad, you're overdoing it a
bit. He's not fully trained. Call an ambulance. Move it!
Danny, help me lie him on the floor.
Shouldn't we
give him a kiss or what? Don't be stupid. You can see he's still breathing. Just help me lie him down.
What's wrong? What do you think you're doing?
Are you okay, Dad?
Just lie back, Mr. Ramsey. Shane's calling an ambulance.
Who needs an ambulance?
You do.
No, I don't. Just had a bit of a turn, that's all.
I hope that's what it was, but it could have been your heart.
Well, look, I'm not getting any ambulance. I'm not going to any hospital. Cancel it right now. I mean, I won't get into it when it comes, so save yourself the trouble.
Then at least go to your doctor. Let him check you out.
Oh, be laughed out of surgery? It's just indigestion on his artery. Surprising after one of Madge's pies. And after hearing these two walk in and tell me they just lost me a fortune.
It's stupid to take risks. It could be indigestion. Great, you can get medication to stop it, but at least make sure.
Now, what do you know about it?
Enough to know you shouldn't take chances with your health. I'm a doctor.
Yeah, a doctor.
Yeah, so I know what I'm talking about.
Well, he knew what to do when you collapsed.
I'll check you out myself.
No, you leave me alone. You, a doctor.
Well, is this it?
Yes.
Here goes. Well, aren't you coming?
I think it'd be better if you go in alone. I'll wait here for you.
But I want you with me.
Rosemary, I've tried to talk you out of this. I think you're making a big mistake. But if you insist on going through with it, it's your decision. Don't ask me to be a party to it.
Yes, it is my decision, and I'd have thought you'd understand. You never hid the fact that I was adopted. Didn't it ever occur to you that one day I'd want to find my real mother?
Not to begin with. But as you got older and didn't ask any questions about her, I thought you were happy with Bill and me, not to be interested.
Oh, Mum, I was happy. And then when I grew up, well, I was so busy with the business, I just didn't have time for anything else. You could say I got out of the way of family life. But now, well, it's different. I'm actually thinking about getting married and maybe having a family of my own.
Well, that could be the best thing that could happen.
Oh, Mum, you sound just like Jim. The only way for a woman to be happy is to have a husband. I thought you were proud of what I've achieved.
I am proud of you, but I don't want to see you turn into a hard and bitter businesswoman.
You know better than that.
Yes, that was a stupid thing to say.
I thought you didn't want to be a party to this, Mum.
I don't. But perhaps I can stop you from being hurt anymore. Heather, this is Rosemary.
Hello, Mrs. Ambrose.
Hello. Won't you come in?
Please, go through.
That you'd be staying, Helen.
I thought perhaps I'd better.
For the last time, I'm not seeing any doctor.
I don't understand how anyone could be so pig-headed about their own health.
Pig-headed? Huh. Great bedside manner you've got. Now, come on. Admit it. You're just having us on. You're no doctor.
I am.
And I reckon he is, Dad. Look, he knew what to do, all right.
Yeah, and the rest of us were pathetic. Shane even thought you were putting it on.
Well, I wasn't. It was just indigestion. Yeah, okay, you're a doctor. A chook doctor.
Yeah, well, there's no point in me hanging around. I'll pop back later to see how you are. Unless you'd like me to drive you to the hospital.
Anybody says hospital, I go... Yeah, all right. You can do something for us. Find out how to get me money back.
Yeah, well, you better see Danny about that, eh?
Yeah. What are you hanging around for, anyway? Waiting for me to drop dead, eh?
I'm hoping you'll see sense. Look, it's not unusual for someone to be scared to see their doctor because they're afraid of the diagnosis.
Afraid? Who do you think you're talking to? I can take bad news as well as an X-Men. I'm not going to win put up me by some chook doctor.
Still, it wouldn't hurt to have a checkup, Dad.
No!
Please, Dad, listen to Clive. He seems to know what he's on about.
All right. He's a doctor. What's he doing running the garden business, eh? Eh?
I wanted to see the real world, all right?
Drop out, you mean? Yeah. No sense of responsibility, you young people today. It was my money put you through university. Pretty damn bad investment, if you ask me.
I understand you want to know about your mother.
Yes, anything you can tell me.
I've always thought it was better not to rake up the past. It's the present that matters.
Yes, but you see, it's my past too, and I believe I have a right to know.
What do you want me to tell you?
Well, everything. I mean, what does she look like? Where does she live? Does she have any other children? Would she be willing to see me?
Darling, give Heather a chance to answer.
I'm sorry. I guess the most important question is, would she be willing to meet me? The rest I can find out for myself.
I'm afraid you can't meet her, Rosemary. Your mother's dead.
But she can't be.
No, don't touch me. You knew all along, didn't you? How could you let me go on hoping?
I'll take as many as you can bake. The customers love
them. Oh, thank you. So does Max. I think I'll have to put a lock on the oven door so he doesn't eat all the profits.
Yeah, well, maybe not. He's just had a bit of a scare.
Oh, what sort of a scare?
He collapsed.
Collapsed? Is he all right?
Oh, he's okay now, but, well, see, it all started when Danny told Max that he backed the wrong horse. And Shane and Clive were there. And Clive was going on about heart attacks. And Max opened his eyes and he wouldn't have a bar of doctors or hospitals. And when I left, Clive was still arguing with Max.
Oh, look, I better get back.
And I think you should talk him into having a checkup. He wouldn't let Clive touch him.
Oh, well, I can't really blame him for that.
But Clive said he was a doctor.
You're kidding.
That's what he said.
Oh, well, stranger things have happened. But look, I really must get back. Max never could look after himself.
I'll give you a lift.
Oh, thank you, Daphne.
Zoe, I'm just taking Madge home.
Yeah, we haven't finished our talk.
This is far more important, Des. We can talk anytime.
Can't win, can you?
I think this is a conspiracy. Daphne and I are just not meant to be together.
Oh, cheer up. Why not stand in here?
Well, all right.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Ambrose. Crying about somebody who I didn't even know. It's just that I was so looking forward to meeting her.
Of course, I quite understand. Now, I expect you'll be wanting to get home.
Oh, no. No, now it's even more important that you tell me everything you know, seeing as I'll never be able to meet her myself.
I think it's better if we do go, darling.
This is what we came for. Where did my parents meet?
At school. They'd been in the same class, and they were inseparable right through high school. Your mother was still at school when she fell pregnant. It was a dreadful scandal.
Oh, so you knew her even then?
Oh, yes, I knew her when it happened. It destroyed her life.
Why couldn't they have got married? I mean, wouldn't one of their families have supported them till my father left school?
That was over 30 years ago. People didn't have the same understanding that they have now. Both families were horrified. They were more worried about what their neighbours were going to say than about their children or the baby.
So she had to give me away.
She had to do much more than that. Her family put her into a home for unmarried mothers and said they never wanted to see her again. Oh, they sent some money, but that was where their support ended.
My father, I mean, didn't he stand by her?
and lose the chance of his tailor-made place in the family business, not likely.
Oh, she must have hated me when I was born.
Oh, no. No, she really loved you. And she desperately wanted to keep you. But with the pittance her family sent, she had to get a job. And how could she look after you?
What an awful predicament to be in. But at least she had one friend. Well, you, I mean, you obviously stood by her. The only thing I don't understand then is why my mother didn't keep in touch. She knew who'd adopted me.
She had to make her own life. Bosses and potential husbands didn't look too kindly on illegitimate children in those days.
But, I mean, when we both got older.
And destroy everything she'd achieved.
You seem to feel very strongly about it, Mrs. Ambrose.
Oh, well, of course. I was her best friend.
So strongly, in fact, you'd think you'd experienced it yourself.
Don't be so ridiculous.
I think we'd better go, darling.
That's it, isn't it? You have. You've been talking about yourself. It's you. You're my mother.
Yeah. But they kicked you out of doctor school. Disbarred you.
That's lawyers they disbar, Dad.
Oh, yeah. Well, defrocked you then. Bet you give some poor coot arsenic instead of aspro.
Lay off him, Dad.
Why should I? Well, he comes in here trying to scare a bloke to death with his quack opinions.
You can easily prove me wrong.
What? Spend good money to have some bloke tell me there's nothing wrong with me? You must think me some sort of mug.
I'm sorry about this, Clive. Well, don't get too excited, Dad. We'll have another attack.
He's really taking you in out. Oh, no. Who sent you?
Nobody sent me. But when Des told me you'd had a heart attack, I rushed straight back to see if there was
anything. I did not have a heart attack!
Calm down, Dad.
I don't know for sure that it was his heart, Madge, but the symptoms were such that it could have been a warning.
Des says you're a doctor.
Yeah.
See, no proof yet.
Well, I don't understand that part of it. What matters to me is what I should be doing to look after Max.
Nothing!
Stop being so stubborn, Dad. It wouldn't hurt you to have a checkup.
No!
Well, look, think about Danny and I for a change. What are we going to do if you suddenly cark it, eh?
Oh, that's nice. Think about yourselves, eh? How am I supposed to feel if I drop dead, eh?
Jane, you're not exactly helping things.
Look, why don't we go next door and let the others make your father see sense,
Yeah, why not? But I wouldn't bet on him getting anywhere.
Typical. No respect.
Ah, let's go.
Oh. Right. Clive, now what's the procedure? A special diet, I suppose?
Diet? Huh? Your pie started the whole thing in the first place.
How dare you, Max Ramsey? There's nothing wrong with my pie.
Yeah, well, how come I was eating one when it happened, eh?
Stop fighting. Dad's sick. And all you can do is yell at each other.
I'm sorry, Danny, you're quite right.
Well, fuss about nothing. What are you hanging around for, anyway?
Just keeping an eye on you.
We can see heart attacks in here, Dad. Then you'll know for sure.
Home diagnosis isn't a good idea, Danny.
Well, put your little mates out of work, eh? This'll shut you up. First signs of a heart attack are shortness of breath, chest pains, giddiness. Yeah, what a book now, eh?
You knew this woman was my mother?
Yes.
So you planned the little sham between you both.
I'm not proud of it. Heather was adamant that you didn't know who she was, and you were adamant about finding your real mother. And the way you've been feeling lately, would you have believed me if I told you the truth?
You didn't even try. And you, did you think I'd land on your doorstep and wouldn't even budge?
No, of course not. And I didn't mean to hurt you so badly.
Then why?
I did love you, really. But I had to forget. I couldn't go on regretting. I knew you were well cared for and loved very much. Besides, I'm married now.
And your husband knows nothing about me.
No, and he's not going to find out.
What's the point of all this? Let's go home.
You're right. It's pointless. And I'm sorry to have caused you so much anxiety. But I don't need a lift, thank you. Surely you'll want to stay here and compare notes with her. See where your little plan went wrong.
Thanks for getting me out of there.
Your dad really means a lot to you, doesn't he?
Oh, yes, he does. That's why I get so mad with him.
He's afraid, you know.
Yeah, and he hides it with all that bluster. He's like a four-year-old kid when it comes to his health. I remember once he was in agony for days with a rotten tooth. In the end, I had to drag him to the dentist.
No, he's not stupid. He sends eventually.
Yeah, I hope so. Oh, what a hell of a day it's been, what with Dad and then Beth Travers as well. I'm really sorry about that, Daphne. I never meant to involve you.
Is it all sorted out now?
I hope so. He's not a bad person, really, just very screwed up.
You missed your vocation. You'd have made a great psychologist.
Yeah, I'm great at recognising other people's problems. Should stop and examine my own motives more often.
Anything in particular?
Of course. Really screwed up our relationship, didn't I?
The breakup wasn't entirely one-sided.
I was just very hurt when you said you wouldn't move in with me. But I can see how selfish I was being now. Daphne, tell me honestly, are you still hoping that you can make things right between you and Des?
That relationship just wasn't meant to be.
Well, then there is a chance for us. I mean, I wouldn't have said anything if I thought that you were still keen on Des, but I won't push you into anything, I can promise you that, but we could start going out together again.
Yeah, why not?
I think Daphne's avoiding me.
Oh, I'm sure she's not. Your timing's all wrong. It's pretty silly to expect her to be able to have a quiet chat while she's at work.
It's not at work, it's those damn Ramseys. First Danny and now Max.
For God's sake, Des, stop blaming everybody but yourself. You know perfectly well that the only reason that you and Daphne aren't happily married now is your own paranoia.
Yeah, well, I just think I'll just forget all about Daphne. She's obviously more interested in Shane than me.
I don't blame her if you're not going to show a bit more backbone.
But damn it, Zoe, how can I be more forceful and aggressive when she won't even talk to me?
I feel we've had this conversation before.
Oh, great, great. Now you give up on me.
Look, there is nothing I'd like more than to see you and Daphne happily married, but it's something that the two of you have got to sort out.
Yeah, well, you tell Shane that.
I don't think Shane's been anything more than a good friend to both of you.
More to Daphne than to me.
Look, Des Clark, I'm going to give you one more chance, and if you can't get it together, then I don't want to hear another word about the pair of you.
Yeah, well, your help hasn't been much use in the past.
Okay, keep wallowing in self-pity, but don't come around here with that gloomy expression anymore. It's bad enough even to live with it.
I'm sorry. Look, tell me your idea and I'll do my best to make it work.
There's nothing new about it. All I was going to recommend was some good old-fashioned courtship. Take her flowers, take her champagne, and then get down on one knee and tell her how much you love her.
Oh, I'd feel really silly.
Probably look silly too, so forget the one knee bit, but do the rest.
Well, I'll try and make it work.
Oh, for goodness sakes, be positive.
Right. I'll sweep her off her feet.
Ah, that's the idea. Throw in a box of chocolates for good measure.
What do you reckon, $3?
Yes.
Great. Thanks a lot.
I thought you were getting a beer.
Yeah, well, I'll change my mind.
Glad to hear it.
Look, why don't you go home?
Why don't you see a doctor?
Yeah, well, I'm not, so save your breath. You want to be useful? Go next door to the Robinsons, get mad, tell them I want me tea.
Oh, I suppose I may as well. I'm not doing much good here. You know where I am if you need me, Danny.
Listen, what have you two been up to, eh? Oh,
nothing, Dad.
Good bloke, Danny. You'd always look after your old man, wouldn't you?
Of course I will. Look, why don't we put our feet up and watch some telly before dinner, eh? That new wildlife program you wanted to watch is on.
You said it was boring.
Nah, might find it interesting after all.
I know Jim had a meeting after work. He should be home soon.
I don't suppose he'd be able to change Max's mind, but it's worth a try.
You're probably right.
Just imagine that Clive Gibbons being a doctor. I always knew there was more to that young man than met the eye.
Rosemary. I didn't mean to... Madge.
Hello, Rosemary.
I'll get it.
Oh. Hi, everyone.
Hello, Zoe.
I saw you coming in, Rosemary. I wondered if I could have a word with you.
Of course.
I want to apply for the job as Paul's secretary.
But he's doing the hiring, not me, Zoe.
Yeah, but couldn't you put in a good word for me? I'd be perfect, honestly. My typing speed's 80 and my shorthand's 120, and I'm used to a dictaphone and taking responsibility.
Hold on. How come such a paragon's been working in a coffee shop?
Oh, I haven't been back in town long, and I wanted something freer than office work for a while.
I'll get that.
Hello.
Yes, hello.
Zoe, what a happy coincidence. Huh? I came to find Madge. You being here is an added bonus.
Oh, is Max all right?
He seems okay. He's demanding his dinner.
I think I better go, Helen.
I'll send Jim over when he comes home.
Thanks. Bye-bye, everyone.
Bye. What's this added bonus business?
I need some fun company.
And I'm just what the doctor ordered, huh?
Ooh.
Oh, sorry.
Doesn't take long for the old jokes to get around, does it? Come on, take me home and entertain me.
Okay.
Bye, Clive.
Bye. Yeah. You'll put in a good word for me, won't you?
Yes, I will, Zoe, but I can't promise anything.
Thanks.
Oh, darling, I've been so worried about you.
I'm so sorry.
I didn't want to lie, but for the first time in my life, I didn't know how to avoid it.
Oh, I don't care.
You know, I feel really relaxed with you, Shane.
Oh, so you should. We know each other's bad habits, so we can relax.
I haven't got any bad habits.
Oh, no?
Name one.
Okay. There's... Well, give me a sec, I'll think of something.
You can't.
Ah, well, that's the worst habit of all, not having any bad habits.
Door's open. I hope you don't mind if I can...
Neighbours, everybody needs good neighbours. Just a friendly wave each morning helps to make a better day. Neighbours need to get to know each other. Next door is only a footstep away. Everybody needs good neighbors with a little understanding. You can find the perfect blend. Neighbors should be there for one another. That's when good neighbors become.